In this video, we'll guide you through getting started using Stream Deck Neo and controlling your computer and apps. When you open your Stream Deck Neo box, you'll find your Stream Deck Neo with a USB Type-C cable. Stream Deck Neo includes an adjustable stand with two angles and also the ability to lay Stream Deck Neo flat. To adjust the stand, open up the bottom. Grab onto the flip-out support with the end of your finger. Then, click it into place into one of the two notches in the bottom. To lay Stream Deck Neo flat, just reverse the process. When using Stream Deck Neo angled up on the stand, keep the USB cable tidy by routing it through the opening in the stand, and then laying it in the notch. This keeps the USB cable flat on your desk. Don't forget to remove the protective film from the bottom to ensure Stream Deck Neo doesn't slide around. On Stream Deck Neo, you'll find 8 LCD keys. On these, you can have hotkeys, shortcuts, websites, even light controls, and so much more, with custom images and animations. Below these keys, you'll find the Infobar. This can be used for showing the time, current page you're on, and more. On the sides, you'll find some capacitive buttons for switching between pages. We'll talk more about pages later. First step is connecting Stream Deck Neo to your PC or Mac using a USB Type-C port. Next, head to elgato.com/downloads and download the Stream Deck software and install it onto your computer. Once installed, open up the Stream Deck software. The app has a few main areas. On the left, you'll see a preview of the keys on your Stream Deck Neo. We call this the canvas. And this is how you'll interact with your device. On the bottom of the software, you'll find what we call the property inspector. Basically, this is where options of an action are. Changing text, hotkeys, volume, that is found here. Click on an action to show what options are available. On the right side, you'll find the actions list. An action is what we call any of the controls or functions you want to do. There's actions for hotkeys, playing a sound file, pausing music, or opening a website. You get the idea. While they're organized into categories for easy browsing, you can also search for actions on the top right. Stream Deck Neo includes a default profile designed to introduce some of what Stream Deck can do for you. Tap on the Apps folder to see Open Actions, which are essentially quick shortcuts to some common applications, like Microsoft Edge, Notepad, or Calculator. Tap on each of these to launch their associated program. Then, tap on the back arrow, and then tap on Links for examples of website actions. Like the programs, tap on these for Stream Deck to open the website in your computer's default browser. We've mentioned the term Pages before. These are one of the ways to organize your Stream Deck. Like the name suggests, you can think of these like pages in a book. Flip the page by tapping on the touch points on the bottom left and right of your Stream Deck Neo. Or you can also change them in the Stream Deck software by clicking through the numbers below your canvas. These default profiles, though, also have full video tutorials included. Tap on the Tutorials folder, and then, in here, you'll have full video walkthroughs of some of the biggest features of Stream Deck, like profiles, folders, plugins, and multi-actions. We highly encourage you to check out these video tutorials to learn how to get the most out of your Stream Deck Neo. We also have fully featured Stream Deck Neo profiles to get you started with live streaming, work-from-home productivity, and of course, playing games. These profiles are available from Marketplace. Links for them are down below in the description. Of course, these are just pre-made profiles. You can create your own for whatever you need. Create a profile for work, where you have shortcuts for Slack channels and messages, and keys for controlling group calls in Microsoft Teams. Another profile for after work, when you're hanging out with your friends in Discord, with your common chat channels and sound effects a key tap away. Create your own profile by going to the profile list on the top left, under the Stream Deck Neo name, and choose New Profile. With a fresh set of keys to work with, drag new actions from the right onto the keys on the left and begin customizing. How about a hotkey action, then a website action, and finally, an open action. Now, selecting the hotkey action, click in the text box and press the keys on your keyboard. This hotkey action will be for saving in a program, so Control and S at the same time. When you tap on this key, it will send Control and S to the computer just like you would using a keyboard. For the website action, select it and type the address to open in the URL text box. Now when you tap on the key, Stream Deck will open that website in your computer's default browser. With the open action, you can of course manually navigate to the application or file to open. However, a quick method is just dragging the file or folder onto the app file box. Stream Deck will then enter the location for you. For program shortcuts, you can just drag the program or shortcut right onto the key. Stream Deck takes care of the rest. Need more room? You can add more pages by clicking on the plus button down in the middle. Remember that the two buttons on either side of the info bar control the page that you're on. If you need even more, you can right-click on an action and choose Move to Folder. And now you can place actions inside of folders for more organization. If you leave the folder and then select it, you can add a custom name for the folder using the text entry in the Property Inspector. On the left, click on the down arrow on top of the icon. Then here you can browse for an image to act as an icon using Set from File, or browse for pre-made images using the Stream Deck icon library. Another quick tip, drag an image or animated GIF right onto the icon preview to add it for an action or folder. And if you need more and more, well, you can put folders inside of folders. But all right, that's enough for now. And these are just the basics. The real power of Stream Deck comes from plugins. You can think of these like apps you'd have on your phone. Want to use Stream Deck to control your presentation? The PowerPoint plugin does the job. You're a streamer and want to control your scenes and sources without touching the software directly? The OBS Studio plugin to the rescue. Controlling your smart appliances, audio software, viewing stock prices, sending sound effects in Discord. There's so much to explore with your Stream Deck Neo powered by Elgato Marketplace. Learn how to install new plugins from Elgato Marketplace. Video walkthrough is linked in the description. Now, if for whatever reason your Stream Deck Neo isn't working like you'd expect, please reach out to our support team at help.elgato.com. Subscribe to us here on YouTube to learn more about your Stream Deck Neo and other Elgato products. Thanks for watching.